Welcome back to another Final Cut Pro tutorial. This one's about how to adjust the way a clip looks in your timeline. Maybe you want to see the waveform. Maybe you want to see a little bit more of the clip so you can preview exactly what is in that moment of time. We're about to show you right now. You can open your clip appearance settings by clicking the film strip icon in the upper right corner of your timeline. The first slider is the zoom slider. This lets us zoom in and out of the timeline. Under the zoom slider, we have the clip appearance buttons. We currently have the middle one selected. This view displays our audio and video film strips in equal size. Our video clips will have a film strip of the video content, and the audio clips will show waveforms. If we click the first button, the timeline will display audio waveforms only. Notice that the video clips no longer have the preview film strips visible, and our audio waveforms are much larger. Clicking the second button, we'll still get a large view of audio waveforms, but now our video clips will also have a small film strip visible. The middle button is the most balanced view, and it will display video and audio clips in equal size. The fourth button will display large video clips and small audio waveforms. The next button will hide audio waveforms and enlarge the video film strips to the maximum size. This last button will hide video film strips and waveforms altogether, showing just their names. The shortcut to change views is Control Option Up or Control Option Down. Using the shortcut, we can cycle between views. The next slider lets you increase or decrease the height of all clips. As we drag the slider, all clips get taller or shorter in unison. So why do these views matter? Well, we might want to work with large waveforms when we're focused on editing audio clips. For example, we can make the audio waveforms large and zoom in. Now we're able to make more precise edits. Likewise, we can make video clips larger, enabling us to edit with more detail and even go frame by frame. Editing styles may vary from person to person, so find a view that works best for you based on what you're working on. So, whether you want your clips in the timeline to be big or be small, now you know what to do in Final Cut Pro. Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level. Ladies and gentlemen, if you enjoyed this episode, please share, like, and tell your friends. Because without your help, no one will know.